children. Today we are going to study the poem Grandpapa's Spectacles by Elizabeth Sill. Is your grandfather or grandmother forgetful? Today we will study what happens when a grandfather misplaces his spectacles. The concept of the poem is love and care towards grandparents. So let's start the recitation of the poem. Grandpapa's spectacles cannot be found. He has searched all the rooms, high and low, round and round. Now he calls to the young ones, and what does he say? 10 cents for the child who will find them today. Then Henry and Nellie and Edward all ran, and a most thorough hunt for the glasses began. And dear little Nell, in her generous way, said, "I'll look for them, Grandpapa, without any pay." All through the big Bible, she searches with care that lies on the table by Grandpapa's chair. They feel in his pockets, they peep in his hat. They pull out the sofa, they shake out the mat. Then down on all fours, like two good-natured bears, go Henry and Ed under the tables and chairs. Till quiet, out of breath, Ed is heard to declare he believes that those glasses are not anywhere. But Nellie, who leaning on Grandpapa's knee was thinking most earnestly where they could be, looked suddenly up in the kind faded eye, and her own shining brown ones grew big with surprise. She clapped both her hands. All her dimples came out. She turned to the boys with a bright, roguish shout. "You may leave off your looking, both Henry and Ed, for there are the glasses on Grandpapa's head." Elizabeth Sill. Summary of the poem. The poem is based on the bond of love between grandparents and grandchildren. In this poem, Grandpa loses his spectacles and he calls his three grandchildren, Henry, Edward, and Nellie, to look for them. But they couldn't find them. In the end, Nellie finds the spectacles right on Grandpa's head. In stanza 1, Grandfather's spectacles are lost and are nowhere to be found. The poet says that he has searched all the rooms but failed to find them. Then he calls all his grandchildren to search for his missing spectacles and keeps a reward of 10 cents for the one who finds the spectacles. In stanza 2, three of his grandchildren, Henry, Edward, and Nellie, run to find the glasses. Little Nell, one of the youngest grandchildren, in her kind way, agrees that she will find them without any pay. In stanza 3, Nellie searches for the glasses all through the Bible and all through the Bible that lies on the table with lots of care. The others look for them in Grandpa's pockets, under his hat, behind the sofa, and under the mat. In stanza 4, Henry and Edward get down on the hands and knees and start looking for the spectacles underneath the chairs and tables, as if they are bears. Finally, Edward declares that those glasses are not anywhere. In stanza 5 and 6, Nellie decides that not to give up, as she keeps on thinking where Grandpa could have left them. Suddenly, she looks up into the kind, faded eyes of her grandpa, and to her surprise, the spectacles are right on his head. She asked the boys, "You can stop looking for the glasses, as they are on Grandpa's head." Message of the poem. The message of the poem is that we should respect everyone, particularly our elders. We should show our love and respect towards our grandparents and should help them in every possible way as they are the precious gift given to us by God. So let's check your understanding of the poem. What does Grandpa promise his grandchildren in return for finding his glasses? Where all do Henry and Edward look for Grandpa's glasses? Why does Nellie clap her hands in the end?